This is Justin Poulin, CEO and founder of Beyond Clean, and we're going to be kicking off the next focus hour here on SPX 2020 with HealthMark. And joining us is Seth Hendy, Clinical Education Coordinator for HealthMark Industries, where he provides expertise on medical device processing, policy writing, and SPD education. Prior to joining HealthMark, Seth worked for 20 years in a central service department with a particular focus on staff education and competence during the last 10 years within the department. And Seth, I can tell you, Beyond Clean, a big fan of education, and the alignment is there with HealthMark and then yourself and your background and experience. So thank you for joining us to kick off this next focus hour on SPX 2020 for HealthMark Industries.
Thanks, Justin. It's great to be here.
So, Seth, let's start. I know most people in sterile processing are familiar with HealthMark, but we have a wide range of listeners, not only in sterile processing, but from the operating room, from infection control, and even other industries like clinical engineering and beyond. So tell us more about the company for those of the audience that are not familiar with HealthMark.
Since about 1969, HealthMark Industries has developed and marketed innovative solutions to aid healthcare facilities in the delivery of surgical instruments and other life-saving medical devices to patients. Some of those solutions are things like products for effective cleaning, validation and verification of the cleaning process, packaging, and other accessories for proper sterilization of surgical instruments. I really enjoy working for HealthMark because I believe they will continue to innovate and continue to support and serve the healthcare providers and support services that make it possible to give the best quality service that they can. And that's why I love working for the company.
That's great. And also always forward thinking. And so as we talk about some featured products today that are going to be highlighted during this virtual expo, there's a theme around reopening and ramping up after a shutdown. And included are the four categories around custom signs and labels, protective covers, instrument retrieval products, and equipment verification. Let's start with the first one. Tell me about custom signs and labels and how it relates to the reopening and ramping up after a shutdown.
We've always needed signs and labels, right? In our department, they're marking off restricted areas and things like that. And we've always needed that kind of stuff to keep people informed. Well, now, especially, we need some very specific signs, do we not? You know, we're talking about signs for social distancing, signs for quarantine areas and things like that. So having some of these floor signs that can actually be easily applied and then easily removed when we get back to a situation where we don't need to do social distancing is something that we think is really important and can be really helpful for a department to try to return to some sort of normal business as these elective surgeries come back and be able to do the things that they need to do. There's a really interesting thing as far as I'm concerned with custom labels too. So while we have those specific to COVID-19 floor signs and wall signs for distancing and washing hands and that kind of stuff, being able to customize a sign, I think, is a really great thing. If you're an organization where a temperature check is something that's now become the new normal for reporting for work, being able to put up a sign to designate that area. If you're one of those places that's now reprocessing masks, having a sign that says this is where your N95 is dropped off is a great application for a custom sign. And all of those things are hopefully going to be there and be able to be used for a facility and a department that's getting ready to try to come back to a higher volume.
All right. So the second category here is protective covers. Tell me about those.
Protective covers, thing that you should have already have most likely in your decontam area. It's really taken on some significance now, though. If you only had that cover over your keyboard in decontam so that it could be wiped off and didn't have one in pack and prep, now you should really be thinking, hey, what kind of things are out there that I may have not thought about applying to my pack and prep area? And so protective covers for keyboards, for phones, for multi-use iPads that work in around in departments now are something that can be very easily applied, removed, and have a new one put back on, depending on what your facility's policy is going to be for frequency of cleaning and changing those things out in those high-touch joint use areas. And again, just trying to let people get back to work safely and have some solutions to help out with that.
All right. And instrument retrieval products?
Yeah, instrument retrieval has been a big thing for us, and it's been a big thing for a long time. You know, OSHA's been talking about solid side leak-proof biohazard containers for many years. They're now taking on a little bit different significance and potentially a little bit of a different use. And so having a good retrieval product, a cart with good bins, seals, lids, latches, things like that are all kind of things now that when you're going out, if your rounding has changed or new procedures in your rounding because of COVID-19, if you're picking up now masks as part of your rounding, you know, those are all kind of things that now we have to think about. We have to think about, is my current solution, is my current product good for this new application? And if not, what can be? And if instrument retrieval through HealthMark is something that you already had, then as I say, a sealed lid and being able to latch the lid down and things like that might actually become advantageous for you to make work if you're trying to incorporate a new routine, such as being out there picking up respirators to reprocess.
All right. And the final category is equipment verification. And then we'll tell everybody about the great content they can expect to see over the next 60 minutes.
Equipment verification is a thing that, again, just like the instrument retrieval, we should be doing. You're in your department, you're expecting your equipment to function, you're expecting it to function properly and deliver a quality product as it comes out. The real kind of question with this and the real reason it should be on your mind is if you had a slowdown or a complete work stoppage, what does that mean for your equipment? If you were just slowing down, it might mean that some of your equipment kept being tested. Hopefully you were trying to rotate its usage. If you're in a large department and had 5 washers, hopefully you were trying to spread that load around if it was going slowly. But if you had any units that were not used in a day, you may not have tested them. It also applies to all the accessories such as the instrument racks and cart washer racks and things like that. All of this equipment verification product is out there just to try to make sure that we're ready to go. Because if the volumes come back and we start having our department staffed again, having the throughput that we need to keep up with those surgery volumes, we want to know that all of our processing equipment is ready to go and functioning at that level that we expect and we rely on.
Over the next 60 minutes, there's going to be some product information in all of the areas that you just reviewed. But as we talked about to kick this off, HealthMark places a great deal of focus on education, and thus you're going to be using your time during SPX to conduct a webinar entitled Safely Reopening Processing Departments, Preparing for Best Outcomes. This sounds like a great one. Can you give us a little teaser before we get started with the webinar?
What we kind of thought is, what don't I know? The big question is always, you don't know what you don't know. There's a lot of news coverage about a lot of different things related to COVID-19. And of course, reprocessing masks, as I've mentioned a couple of times, is one of those big things. But we knew that it was more than that. So as a team, the education department at HealthMark kind of sat down and scratched our chins. And we said, well, okay, if I had to do this, we've got some expertise here. If I was the manager in a department and I was presented with the challenge of bringing my department back and being ready to go, what would I do? And of course, you can't ask every question. So we do make sure that we talk about even risk assessment as something that has to be part of this whole process. But in general, we tried to ask ourselves as many questions about as many products as we could, the equipment, PPE, the supply chain, and all that kind of stuff. And it was great to have John Whalen with me because he has such an expertise in endoscopy that he gave a couple of very key endoscopy components. And those tend to be processing areas that might have been completely shut down. So they have a little farther to go to bring their processing back up.
So how can the audience get more involved?
We love education at HealthMark. And so one of our biggest things was, how do we keep providing it? I love being out. My Saturdays are usually filled with seminars, seeing people, shaking hands, and trying to talk about the topics of the day, the things that are on our mind. So in an effort to do that, we've actually started doing webinars every Friday. There is actually a little library already. So of course you can join with us live. Not only can you do the live ones, we actually have a bank of pre-recorded ones with a few special guests and a few COVID-19 topics about supply chain and things like that. So that is a great way. As always, Crazy for Clean games are something that people should do. It's just fun. We all need CEs, and if you can have a little fun doing it while you're learning, that's never a bad thing. So Crazy for Clean is always something to think about. And then, of course, we have our newsletter. So if you go to our website, you can actually see those webinars and events, and you can sign up for things like our newsletter, where we start to put out thoughts, promotions, any kind of thing that we can help to keep people in a good frame of mind and thinking about what they need to do and how to do it best.
Excellent, Seth. You did a fantastic job. Thank you for participating in SPX 2020. We really appreciate having you on.
We appreciate the opportunity, Justin. It's great.
And as a reminder, before we get started with the rest of the Focus Hour with HealthMark, you can visit their website at hmark.com and sign up for the newsletter there. You can follow them on social media. They have accounts on LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. And if you want more specific information, you can dial 1-800-521-6224, or you can email them healthmark@hmark.com. Enjoy the webinar coming up on safely reopening processing departments, preparing for best outcomes.